Hello, my name is Jeshonga once again, and today we are about to discuss on a topic of knowing and living with yourself. Knowing and living with yourself. We are in this series of life skills where we need to know ourselves so that we can move on with our skills, our abilities, we can move on with all the opportunities that are around us so that we can become better people. Now, when we talk about knowing and living with yourself, the first thing that you need to know for you to exploit your environment is you, yourself. You need to know yourself. Who are you? You need to know who you are. You need to know how to live with yourself. What is the importance of you knowing yourself? If you know yourself, it is going to help you a lot, because there are a lot of skills that you're going to acquire by knowing yourself. There are a lot of abilities that you're going to unleash out. There are a lot of potentials that are hidden in you that need to come out to help you to survive, to help you to live. But the most important thing is that when you know about yourself, it becomes easier for you to respect yourself, to value yourself, to put value into yourself, because you know who you are. That's one of the importance of you knowing yourself. When you know yourself, you can protect yourself, you can guide yourself, you can comfort yourself, because you know yourself. Now, we need some skills in order to help us to value ourselves, in order to help us to protect ourselves. These skills, we are going to talk about them. The skills that are going to help you to understand who you really are. The skills that are going to help you to value yourself. The skills that are going to help you to know who exactly this person, who am I. One of the skills is self-awareness. You need to know yourself beyond your body. You need to know, who is this person? Who is me? Who is me? Some of us, we know ourselves just to a point of identity. We just know ourselves. We don't understand. Most of us, we don't understand ourselves. We just identify ourselves. Our identity is limited only with regards to the names. What are your names? You talk about your names. And from there, you talk about your family lines. I come from this family. And if they ask you to go deeper to talk about yourself, you talk about your institutions, where you are from, where you studied from. Then when they go beyond that, you black out. That means that you still need to learn more about yourself. Your identity is beyond your physical body. Your identity is beyond your name, is beyond your family, is beyond your institutions, where you studied from, where you are from. You are more than that. So this skill of self-awareness helps us to identify ourselves beyond the physical appearance, beyond our names, beyond our family names, beyond our institutions that we work on. We shall look at that skill in details today. But there are also other skills, like for example, self-esteem, to know how what you want and how you set up yourself to get those needs that you want. That is a skill that we need also to learn. Then there is other skills of self-control, controlling yourself in all circumstances, what you're supposed to do, what you're not supposed to do, what is wrong. All those are skills that you need to learn, and they are very important for you to know yourself and to know how to lead yourself. There is assertiveness. That skill is very important if you are to understand yourself. Assertiveness is whereby you know what really you want. Exactly what. People cannot take you away from that one. And you know how to achieve what you want. That is assertiveness. That is the skill that you also need in order to help you to understand yourself. Then there is coping emotions and stress. We need to understand. We need to learn these skills of how can we cope up with the situations where there's a lot of emotion, where there's a lot of stress. So those five skills are the ones that we shall talk about to help us to understand ourselves and also to know how to live with ourselves. But the skill that we want to talk about today is that skill of self-awareness, knowing ourselves, knowing who we are. You ask yourself a question, who am I? That's when you want to start now finding out who you are. You ask yourself a question, who am I? Is it this physical body that we are seeing, the individual you are knowing? Who am I? Really, we want to go beyond your body. Now, we want to go beyond our identities by names. We want to go beyond the identities of our families. We want to go beyond the identities of the institutions where we work or where we study from. The first thing that we need to know, if we are moving beyond that, beyond your name, beyond your body, your physical appearance, beyond your family and your institution, the first thing that we need to know is that we need to know, first of all, our strength. What are your strengths? You need to know your weaknesses. You need to know your threats. You need to know the opportunities. We need to know the potentials that we have in us. Now, these five things are going to help you to know more about yourself. We start with the strength. If you really want to find out who exactly you are, you need to find out about, talk about your strength. What are your strengths? What are talents that you know that these are the talents that I know I perform better? What are those gifts that you have? Do you know the gifts that you have got that you can perform? Do you know the potentials? Do you know the achievement? What are your achievements? How? What about your education? What have you learned? All those ones are your strength and they are part of you. They make who you are. If you want to understand who you know, to know yourself and live with yourself, you need to understand your strength, the talents that you have, the gifts that you have, the values that you have, the skills that you have, the achievements that you have got, the education so far you have got. All that is part of you. That one is going to help you to understand who you are. Then from there, you need also to understand your weaknesses. These are lack in certain things that you are lacking. That those are weaknesses that you have. Do you have any lack in your skills that you're not exploiting very well? Do you have any lack in your goals, achievement in your education, academics? Those lacks that you have that you need to work on, you need to manage, you need to improve areas. You need to know all those areas, your weaknesses, where you are weak. When you know your weaknesses, you know your strength, and then you know your physical body, you know your identities, you know your name, you know your family names, you know your institutions where you go to school, you know the institutions where you work for, then you are in the process of knowing who you are. Now, in most cases, you will find that in a person's life, there are four windows that are going to help us to understand ourselves. Those four windows are what we want to talk about right now. There is the first window, the window where only you know